Good evening to all of you. I am Professor Ashish Pani, who is the Associate Dean for this virtual interactive learning. I am also a Professor of the Information System area. With me, Professor Venugopal is here. He is a Professor in Marketing area. He was our, previously he was the Dean of Institute XLRI.
Good evening.
And with me, to my left, Professor Srimannaran, who is a Professor of HR, who was also previously the head of this virtual interactive learning. And today we were planning to have our faculty colleague, Professor Santosh Sangim, who is from finance area. He is for class. He will not be able to attend this, but any questions related to the finance will be able to respond to that. Now, welcome all of you to this webinar, and I will quickly talk about little brief about the program, then we'll take up the questions which you you have given in the chat. So this program was started by XLRI. You know that XLRI brand, XLRI is a management school, which is the first management school started in India in 1949, and this virtual interactive learning program we started in 2003. Now, 2001-2002. Now, why we started this program is because at one point of time we thought that because so many people after their graduation, after their engineering, they joined the respective job, but they don't, they have not missed the bus of doing the MBA. So we thought that why not we go to the respective cities where the people working and attend the classes together. That's what we thought of collaborating with a technical partner so that we can take the courses of XLRI to the respective cities. Now we have so many technical collaborators. One is UCS, which through which you are now looking to our webinar. We have Hughes Communication Limited, we have Tech Mahindra, we have ICFL, we have NIT Emperia. So through this, we are taking this programs to the students. We have two types of technology. One is that you come and attend the classes in the respective classrooms. Another thing is that today many people are watching this program through their respective laptops. So that also direct to desktop facility is there. Currently, the two programs we offer, postgraduate certificate in business management and postgraduate certificate in human resource management, we have not still offered this program to the direct to desktop. The shorter duration programs, like we talk about EMDPs, which you offer to the direct to desktop. The logic of not offering till to the flagship programs of business management, human resource management, direct to desktop, because at the starting of this program, we thought that if the student will come to the class, there is a lot of peer discussion will take place among the students, because someone may be having from the finance background, someone may be having marketing background. So during the course, there will be a lot of discussion among the participants, and they will learn from each other. Though we just give the concept of the courses in the platform, but a lot of learning takes place from the peers. That's what the objective, why we talked about why we thought about asking you to come to a class and take part in this program. Also, when you do the session through the laptop, desktop at home, possibly a lot of disturbance will come from other parties who are there at home. So that's what we try to avoid that when we are doing this program, and we offer the program to, through the class. And a little about the program, we have two programs, what we call in the VIL flagship programs. We have a postgraduate certificate in business management and postgraduate certificate in human resource management. Now we have 21 courses in each of the programs. It's a 1 year program, and each program will have a very dedicated, I mean a faculty will be offering, and the evaluation of each of the courses will be based on assignment, project, midterm, interim. So it's a rigorous process, and through this rigorous process you will also learn the particular course. That's what I can say, that currently we are running 29th batch of PGCVM and 22nd batch of PGCHRM, 21 batch of PGCHRM. So from that number of batches which previously they have done, around 5,000 people have done this program, so you can make out that the acceptance of this program is there in industry. That's what we are able to continue the 29th batch of PGCBM and 21st batch of PGCHRM. Now, if you talk about the acceptability of this program through the industry, I can talk about that. We have designed the program for skill upgradation. That's what people who are working in the organization, they can upgrade the skill through this program, and they can use that skills in the respective organizations. Now, I have collected data in the initial few years, like many people have done the program, have got promotion in the respective organization, and also people have changed their organization to better organizations to work with. So that's what I can talk little about the acceptability to the program. Now, once you are doing the program, some of the difference between the short duration program and the long duration program is that we offer the campus visit. That's what the campus program is only available in this long duration program, which is not available for the short duration program. Like at the end of this course, you will be getting an alumni status, and also at the end of the program, if you are successfully completing this program, then will be called for a convocation or the graduation ceremony to receive the certificate in the program. That's what the key points, that you will get the alumni status, you will get a facility of 1 week to come to the campus. So that's what you can get the feel of how XLRI looks, and also get merged with the XLRI culture, so that when you go out of the campus also you feel that you are a student of this XLRI. So with this I will stop, and I will request my colleague Professor Sriman Naren to talk about little about the benefit of this e-learning process. Professor Sriman.
Thank you, Professor Ashish. Good evening to you all. I guess the participants who are in this webinar predominantly working professionals who wanted to know about the program. I also guess there are few people from the organizations, representing organizations, probably the HR professionals. So first I would like to address the aspirants. You see, all the working professionals who have put up some experience, or everybody as a matter of fact, including us, every employee, every professional is career oriented. An employee who is career oriented performs the present work given properly, expects due recognition in the form of not only monetary rewards, learning opportunities, and career advancement. In other words, every one of us have the career orientation. So if I was career oriented, there is no other alternative for me except continuous learning and conscious learning to enhance our skills, knowledge, and abilities. That is not enough. It is not simply enhancing the knowledge and abilities. We need to network also. If I have great capabilities, but nobody knows what are my capabilities, I will not grow either in the organization or outside the organization. So especially when I am making an attempt to get outside opportunities, networking is very, very essential. So a person who is career oriented has to enhance his skills, knowledge and abilities and network with the professional people. Yes, I know that many of you are interested in your career, meeting your career goals and enhance your knowledge and skills and abilities by undergoing some courses, some programs from the prestigious institutes like XLRI, and I also know that you want to network with your professional circles, which you would have doing online. that might not be enough. You can, some of you at least would have started early with their graduation. Some of you would have done their post-graduation some time ago or long ago, where they feel that those people, those who have done their post-graduation and experienced working for the, as a professional, maybe it's 8 years, 9 years and all, they might have a problem of career crisis, mid-career crisis. If you want to address all of them, we have to have the learning opportunities. But you will not be in a position to leave the job and join in some prestigious institutes to enhance your skills and knowledge and abilities and earn a postgraduate certificate program. So this is the best way for all the career-oriented people who want to continue their profession and at the same time earn a degree without disrupting their work and their location. Nowadays, as you all know, e-learning is a trend. I was reading some time ago on e-learning initiatives, and that report says, that is Tibco report, says that worldwide market for e-learning has reached to the extent of 35.6 million in 2011. And the productions are predominantly pretty high. And this is the best way for all the working professionals to enhance their skills, knowledge and abilities, perform the present jobs confidently and get career opportunities either inside or outside. So why XLRI? Yes, professor already taught about the unique features of it, but let me share a few of them. Yes, we have a robust technology. We have internet-based delivery system. Our cutting-edge online delivery mechanisms ensure seamless access to the classes, course materials, and you have wonderful opportunity to interact with the faculty members through online and when you come to the campus. Another important thing, networking, that's what I was focusing upon earlier. You can network with your professionals, where you can have more than 150 or 200 working professionals who are in your class from various companies working in various fields. Maybe your field also there is marketing, finance, operations and HR and so on and so forth. So you can network among yourself. For networking, we have a portal also, am I right? We have a portal for networking among yourself within your class, outside the class, not only to enhance your knowledge base, but also to enhance your career opportunities. So these are the special features of our educational online programs. Another important thing is, as the professor pointed out, and I also tell, you can manage your profession, your work, and your academics. So this is what I wanted to tell the people who are aspiring to join this program. With respect to the corporate HR professionals, some of them are there in this webinar. Yes, as I was telling the party aspirants, so HR also can think of this program for their employees to be sponsored. Why it is a better opportunity for the sponsoring your employees? Number one, you can improve. That means there is no dislocation of the work. Other than the campus component, we don't expect the students to work for our program during the working days and working hours. That is number one. Number two, we give a solid certificate once the employee, your employee completes all 20 courses successfully. It's 1 year program. That way you are helping the your employees by providing them learning opportunities. One of the recent studies clearly indicate people leave the organizations when there are not much learning opportunities. That is not number one factor, definitely it is number two. First one is career, the second one is lack of opportunities for learning. So, yes, it is true that every corporate has some budget for this type of learning and developmental opportunities for the employees. You can think of nominating or sponsoring your employees who have to undergo the entire process of selection, that is altogether different. But definitely, this is a wonderful opportunity for the corporates to nominate their employees for our PGCBM and PGCHRM programs. Here, as Professor Ashish Pani pointed out, there might be some confusion for you because there are so many programs which are in the market, even from the XLR side, leave alone other institutes. There should not be any confusion. Yes, it is true that XLRI is into e-learning, and we are the founders of e-learning in the management education. Others have followed, including IIM Ahmedabad, followed XLRI, introduction of e-learning initiatives for the corporate professionals like you. So, as we are the leaders in e-learning, we started doing so many EMDPs across the globe. Therefore, there might be some confusion with our programs. We have finance program, we have strategy program, we have SHRM program. These are all programs which are MDP. We give at the end of the program a participation certificate. The coverage is different. Those people, for them, for those people who will not be in a position to spare this much of time, 1 year program, and attending the exam classes, attending the examinations, so doing the projects and all. If they don't have that much of time, if they want to build their competency in one of the areas of management, let it be HRD, let it be finance or marketing or strategy, those areas we run some specialized EMDP programs. We get we give a certificate. But we don't, as Ashish, Professor Ashish pointed out, no alumni status is given. But for those students who complete PGCBM and PGCHRM, they are integral part of XLR family. You get the membership of alumni and you get all the benefits of alumni once you have successfully completed the program. With this, I conclude my brief talk. May I request Professor Venugopal to take up.
Thank you and good evening once again. Quite a few points have already been discussed. Before I start off, let me also just say that quite a lot of you are present on the other side, which itself is an indication of the interest that you are showing in this type of programs. Over the years, the number of participants or the way the industry is looking at this virtual learning programs or distance learning through satellite and other modes has actually been helpful, and that is the reason why a lot of people are nowadays looking at it. So, coming specifically to how one should really try to look at it, or what is the way that we are going to benefit from this, it is important that, because this is, as Professor Srimanarayan has already mentioned, it is not something that you are doing it immediately after your graduation, but maybe after a few years of experience and all. So the expectations and the objectives from which you are joining this program would be different from any other program which is for a fresh graduate which are there. So if you are looking at joining any program, how are we really going to look at different programs and how are you going to benefit from this program? The first thing that I would look at is that what is the objective for you when you want to join any program. And broadly, based on earlier discussions and all, maybe from your own experience and other things, different people may have different types of objectives. But when we are looking at it, one, I would maybe try to put it into three broad heads. One is career growth. I'm looking at joining a program so that I can move ahead in the career. That would be one very important objective that many of you may be having. Second is to develop problem solving skills, because quite a lot of senior people are also joining this program. So I may not be really looking at any growth or anything, but I want to be in a position to manage the situation. And which is also where there's an overlap between the third type of objective which is there. That is, the market or the environment is becoming so dynamic that I cannot leave away or move away from learning. Learning is something which has to always be on a continuous basis. So when we are looking at a continuous basis and when we are in such a busy schedule, it sometimes becomes difficult for us to really get ourselves abreast to the latest developments which are there. We have a lot of intention and we have everything that we want to do. But then it always gets put aside because, okay, this immediate work pressure or family pressure could put a lot of, that would take priority, and therefore this one becomes less important or maybe pushed to a later date. So if I have a structured program or if there is something which is there, then it is always better for me to put that type of effort or allot the time required for such type of activities which are there. So given these three types of objectives, what is that which we can learn from these e-learning programs which are there? And the first thing I would always talk about is that any level of knowledge which is there is always going to be important for anybody which is there. So upgrading the skills or upgrading the knowledge is always important. And a lot of you are already working and you are already facing a lot of situations where you would have applied a lot of concepts which are there, either correctly or incorrectly or in whatever way. It may have been successful, but there is always a possibility of re-looking at that and improving that. So it's always important to put a structure to that and try to understand how this specific type of event or specific activity has been successful or a failure. And the other advantage which also Professor Shishpani and Professor Srimanarayan are also mentioning, that if I am in a classroom type of environment, it is not only my way of allowing the concepts to superimpose on my experience, my own experiences, but also gain from the knowledge and experience of other participants of not only one industry, but several industries. So what has been the way that a concept or a situation has been handled in one industry or another industry? What are the type of difficulties? What is the way in which we are actually facing, and how do we learn from other people's mistakes or other people's experiences which are there? So that is another very big advantage of having a classroom type of orientation rather than just downloading something and trying to read. So here, when I'm interacting, when I'm able to question myself or put the question across to other people, the whole interactive learning is also something very important. And that is something which I always say, learning is maybe half of the learning we may get from the faculty, but the remaining half you will be able to get from your own understanding of the market or your environment and your participants. So that is one important aspect which you are looking at when you are talking about career type of thing, so that you can apply all concepts into your day-to-day type of situation, as well as look at it from the situations which are new situations, because a lot of newer challenges may emerge. So how do I face newer challenges? That is one very which important type of learning that you will be looking at. And when we are talking about from a problem solving type of situation, many times when we are in a problem, it is always important to go back to the basics. Quite often we ignore the basics or forget the basics. So if I go back to the basics, I can also be in a position to identify the problems much better. And that is another advantage of having a very structured and a program which goes right from the basic concepts to the higher level concepts, so that I don't ignore the basics. And maybe adding a point of what Professor Sriman Narayan has mentioned, the smaller MDP type of programs are very specific programs for a very, maybe a single concept, I mean not a single concept, single functional area or anything. But when we are doing a year-long program, this is where we start with even re-looking at the basic, revisiting the basics, so that we understand and re-look at the, how the whole basic issues are there, and then build on the framework. So the whole framework which will sit on this will help us to understand how to look at the problems, how to solve the problems, and how to really help us in all the objectives. So if you look at all the objectives, whatever the objectives are there, it is up to you or up to all of us to see how we can really apply. And that is the advantage that you have, because you have very clear-cut goals and clear-cut objectives. So whatever is being taught, you can modify it to the way it is going to suit you. And I'm sure that this is something that will be of very important, great importance to all of you. And as I said, since quite a lot of people are already here, it is an indication that there is an interest for certain programs like this. And I'm sure you'll be able to benefit from this. And I think I will stop here and maybe I'll hand it over to Professor Pani.
Thank you, Professor Venugopal and Professor Sriman Narayan. So that's what we talked a little in brief about the program, and I think both the speakers talked about that doing a basic course on business management, human resource management is important to know the basics. Then after that, if you are interested, possibly we have a very short duration programs for specialize on some particular function, like someone is interested in strategy, someone is interested in finance, someone is interested in HR, some specific competencies. Suppose some specific courses are offered here in this platform. So don't get confused with our certificate program and the postgraduate certificate program. I re-insist again, the postgraduate certificate program is a one-year program, which is a very basic program, and which is the flagship program of our VL program, which is running, again, I repeat again, the 29th batch of PGCBM and 21st batch of PGCHRM, which itself talks about the acceptability of this program in the industry. Now, going back to the course structure, like when we designed the course structure in 2002, we have taken the industry input. Like, we have not designed from our side, we have taken the industry input, that what is the input the student will be comfortable with, which will be needing, the industry will be needing that. That's what possibly I am addressing to the HR managers or the managers who are in a decision making to sponsor their candidates. This is the feedback which you have taken from the industry and designed the course content. And it is not once that we have done in 2002, every time the batch which pass out from the institute, they give the feedback, what are the course modifications, which you need to update, which you need to do. So that's what time to time we incorporate that. And the positive point of this is that looking to the course structure, currently we have 15-20 corporates who are sponsoring their candidates to our program, like big financial institutions like BirlaSoft, Wipro, some of the banks, they sponsor. That's what I'm talking about, 15-20 corporates. They are regularly sponsoring 15-20 students to our program. That, again, itself speaks about the acceptability of our program through the corporates. And to the last part, which I can talk about, that I was talking about, which Professor Sriman Narayan was talking about, in the career, competency, capability, all these things are important, but more important is the networking. That's what we provide, the facility for you to network with your partners, network with your peers, And also, we provide a facility like a placement facility. We don't support that placement facility. We just facilitate a virtual placement, and we have created a virtual placement notice board through which you can place your CV so that people, we have opened to many of the corporates are member of a virtual placement notice board. They can see it, and if it is required, they can talk directly to you. That's what the process we have started some 2 years back. Now, that's working fine, and I can tell a positive thing about that. So possibly, that's one possibly good thing about this program, that your batch people know each other so well, they recommend themselves to their organization, and sometimes you put your CV in the virtual placement notice board, and you get calls from different corporates who are member of our placement notice board. So that's what few positive points we talked about it. Now I will take some of the questions which is asked by the participants. So please feel free to write your comments in the note chat so that we can take question what you are asking. What is your query that we can discuss in the platform. So first question which you people have asked about the related to career, how it is going to help, how this UCBM is going to help in your career. That's what I was telling it before. I repeat it again. That's what don't get confused about the acceptability. That's what I was talking about. I repeat again. The number of bases will talk about the program's acceptability in the industry. If it is not acceptable, so many students should have not done this program. And that's what the help in the career, it has helped many people have done this program through this platform. That speaks itself about the acceptability of this program by the corporates, by the students who are doing this program. It is really upgrade the skill of the people who are doing this program. That's what few questions are there on the skill. How it will upgrade my skill. It is really, this program is designed for upgrading the skill of the people. That's what all the content what we have done in the program is of 300 hours and 20 course and project. So that is basically designed for upgrading the skill of the people. So that's what you at the end of the program, you will really feel the upgradation of your skills. If you have any reservation, that's what we are talking from XLRI, so we'll talk positive about it. But if you have still reservation, you talk to some of the, because we have 5,000 alumni in the industry, so possibly if you want to talk to any of the alumni, we can, if you are not able to find out anything, you write to XLRI. We'll try to give you some 5-10 names where you can talk and get to know about this program more. That's what the people who have done the program, they are our brand ambassadors. They talk about our program. That's what they are the, from the word of mouth, people come to know about our program. That's what in the last year when we are interviewing the students for our last batch, I was asking each of the participants how you come to know about this program. In 99% cases, it is recommended by their colleague who has done this program before. If a colleague who has done this program, if he is having a bad experience, possibly he will not recommend to one of his colleagues. So that itself again talk about the program's acceptability and the skill upgradation. Now we'll look into the questions and we'll take questions one by one. And I will now request Abira, who is coordinating with us for this program, who has initiated this webinar. So I'll request Abira to read the questions so we can address that.
Thank you, Professor. There are a couple of questions that have come in. So one question we would take up right away, that is that has come from Ms. Subodh Saluja, who is from Gurgaon. Her question is, what is the minimum and maximum experience level of candidates that are required for such programs?
The minimum level of experience, which are that managerial experience of 2 years, though we talk about this is the qualifying standard to apply, but in average 7-8 years experience people come to this program. In average I'm talking about, there are people who are having 12-15 years experience and
even 20 years
even experience. 20 years experience. That's what last batch one person was having 20-25 years experience. He did his postgraduate in business management from IIM Ahmedabad. He wanted to do the HR course from XLRA. So in the interview I asked that you are in such a senior position, why you want to do this program? He said that I did business management, I want to know HR, so for HR XLRA is the best place to know about this concept. So that's what I am in a very senior position now, I know, I want to know about the HR concept. So that's what I am joining XLRA's HR program.
So there is no upper limit.
There is no upper limit.
So you can join at any time.
You can, that's what, but the minimum thing is that we talk about 2 years, because the concept which is taught in this program, if you have a little work experience, you can relate with. If you are a fresher, possibly you will not be able to relate things which is discussed in the class. The cases which is discussed in the class also, you can relate to the situations in the organization. That's what we prefer. We say that the eligibility criteria is 2 years experience, but as I was talking to you, that 8 years experience, the average experience is 7-8 years.
So here we go with the next question that has come from Indore, that is Mr. Akshat Srivastava. He wants to know whether these programs are too hectic in terms of assignments, projects and tests.
Yeah, you learn in the process of, so if it is not hectic, that's what you will take admission at the end of the year, you get the certification. Anyone can do that. But we try to focus on the rigor of the course. So in the process, you will learn at the end of the year, when the program ends, you will learn if the rigor is there. Because if you are not writing any assignments, if you are not doing any project, the learning is minimal. So you will not gain anything out of the course. So it's a very rigorous course. So that's what when you are doing the program, you have to give specific time each day for this program. If you give 1 hour, 2 hour time in a day, then possibly it will not be too difficult to do this program. But I repeat, this program is rigorous. This program will take your time, but at the end of the year, you will learn a lot from this course. That's what I can guarantee.
Now just to add, when you look at the effectiveness of the program, if you are able to link up your projects to some of the problems or situations in your own organization, that can also be something of value to you and your organization also. So that is one added advantage that can be there, where you can look at how you can manage or look at your day-to-day problems or issues from the projects and other things which are there. Just thought I'll add that.
One question from Mumbai we'll take is Ashwak. He said that how is this course different or similar than the full-time courses of XLRI?
Yeah, I can give us just the idea that full-time course, they stay here in the campus 2 years. And that is a 1200 hours program. Now this program is designed for mostly people in that regular program. Also we prefer with work experience, but freshers also come to this program. So that's what we start very basic things, and we teach them for 1200 hours. They stay in the campus for 2 years. And this program is designed for working executives. So that's what we start from a next level. So that's what we designed the program for 20 courses, 300 hours. So in the regular program, they do 40 courses and 1200 hours. So that's the basic difference. And in terms of candidates who apply for this, our regular program is around 1 lakh. And possibly this will be 5,000 people are applying for this, our this VIL program. So that could be the difference.
Thank you, Professor. The other question that Ms. Vinita, she is connected with us through New Delhi. So she has a question with regard to as in how to interact with the faculties and which is the option rather, and along with that, it's like if she enrolls for PGC HRM, then what would be the benefit with regard to course duration, cutoffs, etc. She's already pursuing a certification program with XLRI, the HRM program.
This is SHRM?
Yeah.
Okay, shall I answer this? Okay. You see, yes, there is one program we are already doing that is in collaboration with SHRM. SHRM, that program has only some 6-7 courses. Each course is for 9 hours. Then a course is 9 hours. Here the every course, say for example, learning and development, that is one of the courses within those 6 courses of SHRM. That is an MDP for us. We will not be in a position to compare the content of SHRM with the content of SLRM. Here we have to teach 15 hours. In SHRM program, we are teaching for 9 hours. Therefore, this is the first time it is happening. Therefore, we have not we decided whether we have to give any concessions and all. If it is concessions, how we can definitely give concession. If it is duration is if it's 15 hours is there, that is okay. But this type of the things, that program may be helpful for better understanding. This is an EMDP for us. A person who attends the EMDP wants to transfer the, there are no credits in that which you can transfer to this program. But definitely you will get a certificate from XLRI, that is an MDP type of certification. But no special additional benefits you get, you have to undergo all the courses. But one advantage is, your effort will be less. Now 50% of the courses, what are those 6-7 courses, six courses only, which you are going to study. Then we teach the same subjects in this VIL mode, in this program. Your learning will be more reinforced. That is the advantage.
Thank you, Professor. Now, there are a couple of questions that have come with regard to the selection and shortlisting process, wherein one question has been posted for Professor Ashish K. Pani, that is from Mohammed Irfan, Bangalore. He says that I have heard that there are many senior professionals who take part in this program. He personally has 4+ years of experience and specialized in recruitment aspect of HR. So now he wishes to know that if he at all he is a part of this program to understand the other functions of HR, to get used to these concepts and all, so how would this help? How would this help him?
That's what I was talking about. This is a program which is designed taking that in mind. So there are 21 courses in this program. So that's what, suppose one function you are currently doing, that's what recruitment and that training some aspect. So all the other aspect you will be able to learn during this program. I will request Professor Sreeman to throw some light, because he's a professor in HR. He will talk about the particular courses which will add value to you and how it will help you.
If you are aiming at PGC HRM, we have 20 courses. All those 20 courses, some of them are basic courses like fundamentals of HR, fundamentals of industrial relations. But if you move on, we will get some advanced courses also. We have a course on strategic HR, we have a course on performance management, executive compensation, learning and development, organizational behavior, organizational structure and change. So that way we have, in addition to that, for HR professionals, we believe that HR mastery is not enough. They need to have business mastery also. Therefore, we teach in HRM program a few courses of marketing, finance, strategy, and operations. So that way, this program would be helpful for a recruiter who wants to take up a full-fledged HR role in the same organization or a different organization.
This will certainly help you to learn the total HR function better. That's what possibly you are doing one function now. So that will, this program will help you to understand HR as a whole. Like that's what Professor was talking about, that HR as a business partner which you are talking about. So to know that, possibly you have to understand all the other functions of the organization also. That's what is a part of this program. So you will certainly get benefit to learn this whole HR functions.
If I like, may I add, just when I was talking about the objective, if your objective is career growth, your whole idea is to get a much more global or a holistic picture of the entire function. So you may have worked in a specific functional area, you may be an expert in that. But if you move up the ladder, you need to look at the other functions. So that is more important, and that objective, as I said, once I know my objective, that is how I can use the program.
Thank you, Professor. One question has come from Riyadh, that is Mohammed Noshar. He says, can we know all the students during the course, doing the course in the same time, in the same program, in order so that we can communicate with each other?
Yes, I think you know that for the day it starts from the first day. They have typically they have a WhatsApp group, and they discuss most of the thing in the WhatsApp group. And one best part of it is that all of you will come to the campus. That's the campus program. The campus component is compulsory, so that you can come to the campus and have a interaction with us, also with your peer. Like suppose you are doing a program in your respective place, but when you come to the campus, you will see all the participants from the different cities and can interact. That's what we say, that when you come to the campus, don't mix with your only city people. You mix with all the other city people so that you can interact, so possibly you get to know more about the profession. So that's what is the best part of it. We create a facility for you to interact among yourself.
Thank you, Professor. One question we would be taking up, which has come from Jaipur. She is Miss Nisha. She says that after pursuing this PGC, HRM or BM, can we go for further education? Can we pursue further education in abroad?
Answer is no, because we thought up while designing the course, we keep in mind that it is the skill upgradation course. So that's what we have kept in that mind. So that's what we have not, you cannot use this for any program outside India or in India also.
It would be equivalent to a master's degree.
Yeah, it is not equivalent to a master's degree. It's a certificate program, but quite recognized in industry, corporate. So it is acceptable in the industry. For acceptability of this in the corporates is very high, but for higher education, if you want to do a PhD or master degree, it's not
a disqualification.
Yes. Yeah, but if you have another post-graduation,
you
if
can.
You are joining any other institute, you can maybe use this as a
advantage.
Yeah, not only advantage, some institutes may give you credit waiver or other things, but by this itself, you will not get the eligibility, because this is not, UGC does not give you an equivalence to a master's program.
Thank you, Professor. Lastly, we will be taking up another two questions through this chat. One question is, which has come from Noida. The person says that with so many courses that are there in the market these days, from various premier B schools and their domains also, so which would be that one reason that the participant should opt from this for the BL program from XLRI?
The best part is that's the difficult part, or the best part of this program is the rigor of the program. That's what I was telling, that the people who have done this program during the program, they say it is difficult, painful, but after doing the program, they recommend to their almost all in their corporate to do this program to learn, because that's what I'm talking about. If you don't slog during the program, you would learn nothing out of this program. At the end, you will get a certificate, but that certificate you will not use if you don't upgrade your skills. So that's what I can say, that program you choose, there are so many institutes offer the program, but you choose a program where rigor is there, where you can learn something out of it. That's what possibly people are doing it. And people who have done this program, people say that if you want to do a virtual interactive program, do it from XLRI. That's what the difference I can say that. Like all the classrooms offer the courses from different institute. But if you go and talk to the classroom coordinators, they will talk about XLRE program, the acceptability is high. Yeah, I'm not telling that because I'm working in XLRE, but for that you can go and check with our classrooms. There are so many classrooms across the country. You can go and check with the classroom coordinators. They will talk about which program's acceptability is there by the students. So that will speak about our program.
You see, the same coordinators run programs of other institutes also. They don't run exclusively XLRI programs. Other institutes programs also, they say, for example, JUKES or ECS earlier, they used to conduct IIM programs also. So that means the class coordinators are the same, either for XLRI program or IIM program. So whatever they say, you can...
Thank you, Professor. This is the last question that we would be taking up through chat, and this has come from Ganga Goel, Hyderabad. He says that how PGC DM will give edge to my career. I have been in people management and accounting and finance and taxation for the last 12 years after passing out my CA in 2002.
She wants to move to HR.
Yeah, he wants to know how would PGC DM give an edge to his career.
PGC DM.
As a chartered accountant, possibly you are good in accounting. That's what you have been doing it. But you may not be open to the other functions which is there important for to run a business. So possibly this course, PGCBM, will give a basic idea about all the other functions of the business. So you can do your work much better way. You can perform your work much better way after doing this program. Currently, possibly your view is very narrow about the accounting. That's what possibly you are doing it for the last so many years. So after this program, you will be able to look whole organization as a whole and do perform much better.
If I want to extend, you might be doing the same job even after doing the PGCVM, but you will be doing it with much more confidence than you deal with various whatever internal or external stakeholders.
Thank you, Professor. Now it's like we would be giving you all the opportunity to call in. We would be taking only two live calls as there is a time constraint. So this is the number that is being flashed. So any of you all who are interested can call on this number and the professors would directly answer your calls.
Sir, I also have one question.
Yeah, tell me.
Sir, actually, right now I am in Dubai.
Dubai. Yeah. Okay.
So, when I enrolled for this course, I would be in Mumbai. But probably in 6 months down the line, I might have to shift to Delhi. So, I mean, will that be feasible for me to take up the, to continue the course from Delhi? Because I'll have a group which will be formed here in Mumbai.
Yeah.
And probably we would continue with certain assignments also in group, but then later on if I shift to some other place, which is Delhi, will that be, I mean, will I be able to do justice to the course then?
It's possible. What you are talking about, that you, for initial days, you will be in Mumbai for 6 months, and then possibly there are chances that you may move to Delhi. So it depends on the number of seats available in Delhi. So we can accommodate you in that classroom, and possibly the group which you are doing for the first 6 months, possibly you have to work with a different group. That's what, but it is possible, and that's what another that's what we have not talked about this, that many times the working executives move during their course. So, you suppose you are from Delhi and you are going to Mumbai for some work, official work, and you don't have to come back to attend the class from Delhi. If you are there in Mumbai, possibly if there is a seat available in that particular classroom, you can attend that class from there. That flexibility is there in this program.
Actually, I joined in this certificate course of HR. Probably next year I would be going to South Africa. Can I upgrade myself into PG course? Can I take up the course?
No, you can take up this course. You can enroll for this PGCHRM with UCS now, and that SHRM also you can continue. There is no harm.
Okay. So I can apply for any faculty job or lecturer job in South Africa if I take up the PG course.
If you take up the
course. What is the basic qualification you have?
I've done my MBA and I've got 5 years of experience in HR itself.
So yeah, you can apply with this qualification. You can apply for the faculty position because you have a master's.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, Professor, I'm currently a student of PGCHRM batch 19.
Yeah.
My query is just like, so we had a camp component month of May. Mm-hmm. I just wanted to understand, is there any plan of like, we have a awesome, like very good understanding of labor law classes. Like, so there are similar courses like managerial counseling and many other courses which require no direct interaction with the professor, which gives you a better understanding.
Mm-hmm.
So going ahead, is there any the plans of, you know, at least expanding the number of campus components we have?
No, we don't currently, because initially we thought of having two components, but problem is that we cannot accommodate you in the campus. That's the problem. And if you're really interested for some of the that courses, and we run some of the MDPs in campus, you are free to attend those in campus MDPs so that you can have a direct look face to face interaction. And currently, if you are interested in the labor laws, we are planning to start a program specifically designed for labor laws in this VIL mode. So even if you do that program, that will give a lot of clarification, doubts, clearance about the labor laws to you.
So, Professor, like, how do we get in? Like, just now, we don't have any info, like, which courses. So, is it like, any mail or
any program, we'll update in the website. You just have a look to our website. We'll update that website about that. And if you are a student, you will feel free to write to VIL office. Any information they will provide you.
Okay.
Before closing, I will repeat that what I was talking about, there is a lot of confusion about our postgraduate certificate program and short duration programs. I re-insist that the postgraduate certificate programs are our flagship programs for the VIL mode, and that has again three benefits which I was talking about. You will get the alumni status, you get a campus feel by attending the campus component, and you get a networking facility to your peers through a different platform, and we provide a facility of a virtual placement notice board which you can use. So with that, we close here and thank all of you. If you have any clarifications we have not cleared, so feel free to write to VIL office. We'll respond to each of the questions which you have asked. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.